as I spin in vanity and pride.
Yeah.
walking up that hill, giving his life and dying, but it did not end there. On that third day, he rose victorious and gave us victory. Because he rose, we have victory. Amen? Let's do that old song.
Well, I heard an old story, how to save the king from glory. Heard about the streets of gold. I've got victory in Jesus. There's always hope in Him. Amen. Simone's songs were requested, so I'm going to try my best. Righteous forsaken, and He'd never see His seed begging bread. Are you His seed tonight? Are you His children? Then we ain't got nothing to worry about. I don't put my trust in armies. I don't put my trust in horses and chariots. I put my trust in the man of war, and His name is the Lord Jesus Christ. And He'll fight my battles and win every time. Amen? I just want to remind you that He'll come through for you. Picture Moses by the Red Sea shore.
Grace and mercy this morning, and how it's extended to that deepest, darkest sinner that may be even sitting on death row tonight. The love of God has no boundaries. He loves the sinner. He hates sin because he's holy. But nobody loves the sinner even more than Jesus Christ. Amen? His mercy and grace goes far beyond anything we could ever do or anything we could ever say. We can't even comprehend that kind of love, mercy, and grace, but he gives it to us every day. Amen? And another request that came through is to share Bill's testimony and his song tonight. And I hope it blesses somebody that's watching or somebody here tonight, but you don't have to be raised a preacher's kid like I was. I was raised in church from the moment I was breathing. And that's a testimony in itself. I wasn't supposed to live. My lungs weren't developed. But I thank God I had some praying parents that not only could just say a prayer, but God filled them with the power to be able to touch heaven for me. The Bible says to pray, but also pray in the Spirit. He says to sing, but also sing in the Spirit. Everything we do has to be in the Spirit. Amen. You can only serve Him in spirit and in truth. But my parents got a hold of God for me, and when the doctor said that baby won't live through the night, giving me a bad prognosis, putting me in a machine that's breathing for me. But I believe in the power of prayer. It has not diminished one bit. And what seems impossible to us is always possible with God. Amen? After that prayer in the Holy Ghost, the doctors came in the next morning and said, that baby girl took her first breath on her own, and you can go ahead and take her home. And y'all, I've been singing ever since, and I'm going to keep singing to the day I die. He gave me breath. He gave me life. But you may not have been raised in church like me. You may not have been able to be blessed enough to see blinded eyes open like I have. You may not have been blessed enough. I don't say fortunate. I say blessed. To see people that were crippled be able to walk. You may not have been blessed enough to see people that were hurting and dying and hopeless for God to speak peace into a situation and then be able to have the strength to get up and face the day again tomorrow. I have been blessed in my lifetime. I have seen God do mighty miracles. But there's still no greater miracle than the mercy and the grace of God to save somebody. And I get emails and requests all the times from mamas and grandmas and aunts and begging us to pray. Begging us to pray for their loved one that it seems hopeless. It looks hopeless. They're strung out on drugs, or they don't even know where they are tonight. And it looks completely hopeless. But all I can pray is for God to send mercy. Like He did for Bill. He wasn't raised like me. And this is my husband of 24 years over here on this guitar. But when I met him, he was 14. Completely, completely rebellious from the lifestyle he was used to. Drugs and alcohol, gangs, juvenile detention. It felt like nobody really cared. But again, somebody who believed in the power of prayer was praying for God to send His big hand of mercy to cover Bill's life. That didn't save him. Just saying a prayer of, Lord, forgive me of all my sins, and that didn't make his life perfect. But in a juvenile detention, he said, God, if you'll get me out of here. They wanted to put him away until he was 18 years old. But the hand of mercy, the judge said, just go live with Grandma. And Grandma was that one who had been praying. Amen? And the mercy of God was extended to Bill's life. And what should have been a life of crime, what should have been a life of possibly therapy, possibly a broken marriage, possibly death from the drugs, God turned that life completely around and restored it. Restored what the devil had stolen. That's the mercy that we sing about. That's the mercy we preach about. There's no loved one that's gone too far that God cannot save and restore those years that's been stolen. Amen? I believe that with all of my heart. And Bill, they want you to sing that song that you sing all the time. It never gets old because we all need the mercy of God. Amen?
I stood in the courtroom. The judge turned my way. It looks like you're guilty. Now what? say. I spoke up, I said, Your Honor, I have no defense. But that's when mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand of God's saving grace. The blood was presented that covered my sin, forgiven when mercy walked in. I stood there and wondered, how could this be? Someone so guilty had just been set free. My chains, they were broken. I felt bound again the moment when mercy walked in. And mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand of God's saving grace. The blood was presented that covered my sin, forgiven when mercy walked in. The blood was presented that covered my sin, forgiven when mercy walked in.
Mercy tonight. Come on, Mama, come sing us something.